Hello, today we will take a look at the macOS Sequoia 15.4 update, the final release, its new features, and a step-by-step installation guide. I will install the macOS Sequoia 15.4 update on the MacBook Pro M1 and inform you if I encounter any issues during the update process. Before updating or upgrading, backup your Mac in advance or clone your internal drive to an external one to prevent any potential data loss. Apple released macOS Sequoia version 15.4 on March 31, 2025, which includes the following new features. Apple Intelligence on Mac, iPhone, and iPad has expanded into more languages and regions. The macOS 15.4 update includes the following languages: French, German, Italian, Portuguese, Spanish, Japanese, Korean, and Chinese, as well as localized English for Singapore and India. I tried out the Japanese language, and the Apple Intelligence writing tools were able to proofread and summarize the Japanese text. The latest release of the macOS 15.4 update now supports SDUC secure digital ultra capacity cards exceeding 2 terabytes in size on Macs with Apple Silicon, which includes an internal SD card reader. Another new feature in this update is the addition of 7 new emojis in macOS Sequoia 15.4: face with bags under the eyes, leafless tree, fingerprint, harp, root vegetables, shovel, and splatter. With the latest release of macOS Sequoia 15.4, you can now organize your Apple Mail inbox into 4 categories. Primary: list your important emails, including personal messages and those that are time-sensitive information. Transactions: these are emails concerning your orders, receipts, and product deliveries. Updates: include your newsletters, appointment reminders, and subscription-related emails. Promotions: in this category, you will discover emails highlighting offers and deals. The image playground in the macOS Sequoia 15.4 update introduces a new sketch style. To create one, click the pop-up options, select Sketch, enter your description into the prompt box, for example, a cute dog in the garden, then press Enter on your keyboard. If you want to change the style, simply select a different one, such as animation. The Passwords app in the menu bar now includes a minor new feature that displays a countdown timer for verification codes, indicating the remaining time before the code expires. Another new feature is called Proximity Pairing. This feature allows you to pair your iPhone running iOS 18.4 with a new Mac during setup, making it easy to transfer information like your Apple account to your new Mac. macOS 15.4, the final release, improves the performance of macOS Sequoia and system stability by addressing bugs from the previous beta versions.
If you like this video, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell for more. Thank you.
To update your macOS, click System Settings in the dock, then General, Software Update, and Info. The macOS Sequoia 15.4 update is 1.56 gigabytes on my MacBook Pro M1. I will install it over the 15.4 release candidate 1. The update size may differ depending on your current macOS version. Once you are sure you want to update, click Update Now. Next, agree to the terms. Enter your admin password and click OK to install. The installation has started, but it will take some time. I will pause recording the video and resume when the installation is complete. I will also let you know if I encounter any problems during the installation. The installation of macOS Sequoia version 15.4 is now complete. It took approximately 12 minutes on the MacBook Pro M1. It may take longer on your Mac. The Apple logo and a progress bar appeared 4 times throughout the installation, including one black screen that lasted about 30 seconds, followed by a progress bar that took about 15 seconds to complete. I didn't encounter any issues during the installation process, and I can now run macOS Sequoia 15.4 on my M1 MacBook Pro. However, it's possible to face issues while using this update. If you haven't installed macOS Sequoia on your compatible Mac yet, I recommend performing a clean installation to avoid annoying issues in the future. Watch this video to learn how to do a clean installation. You can access the link in the description box by clicking on More below this video. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on my profile picture and sharing the video links with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.